One thing that we're keeping our eyes on, now that there's funding for an expansion of the protected area system so that BC can reach its minimum protection target of 30% by 2030, is to ensure that going forward, that protected areas standards and permanency are upheld. In British Columbia, right now we've got strong protected areas like the traditional provincial parks, but we also have provincial conservancies, which are more congruent to First Nations rights and title. They protect First Nations subsistence rights and cultural use, hunting, fishing, foraging, cutting down cedars for cultural purposes as opposed to commercial resource extraction. And we've also got a forest reserve system, a conservation reserve system, like old growth management areas, where boundaries under industry lobby can still be moved and they can log in some of those areas, and they'll often trade it for less valuable timber. And wildlife habitat areas, and in some of those designations, they can actually log in them. So we need to close the loopholes in those forest reserve systems because those are important parts of the conservation and protected areas networks. And we have to make sure you can't move them around as a result of industry lobbying. Now, the province is also looking to establish a new designation for protection, and they may be moving towards flexitarian standards that allow for logging to take place in those areas. That is a no-go. If you're actually looking at conservation of endangered ecosystems, often places like this, like the ancient big leaf maple and Sitka spruce, is a minuscule fraction, not even 1% of the larger landscape area. And so if you let in logging and commercial resource extraction in so-called protected areas, you can easily exterminate the most endangered ecosystems and species at risk. Protected areas standards and integrity and permanency has got to be upheld moving forward. Otherwise, don't count them as protected areas.